Hey y'all, Coach in the Fight here. Want to talk to you about guardian angels. Yep, we've always heard about guardian angels. They kind of put it in the cartoons, like people have a guardian angel around, but they're not really covered in the scripture anywhere. You read in the Old Testament or the New Testament or even the apocryphal books, and you don't hear anything about any guardian angels, to any detail. We kind of know that they're there, but they don't give us any information. Until the third testament of the Bible. That's right, guys. We're going to come out of the third testament of the Bible for this one. We're coming all the way up here to chapter 41 and verse 10, where we're going to hear about guardian angels. All right? So let's pick right up. He says, "You do not travel alone, for my encouragement and my light go with each one of you. But if that seems little, I have placed with each human creature a spiritual being of light to watch over your steps, to make you foresee certain dangers, and to serve you as company in your solitude or as a staff on your journey. They are the beings you call guardian angels or protectors." Yep, guys, the third testament of the Bible explains these guardian angels. And what does it tell us about these guys? He says, first of all, he says that every human being has them. He says each one of you. So everybody has a guardian angel. Not just the elect or the 144,000, but everybody on the planet has a guardian angel. Right? And then what he says here, he says that he has placed them here. He's given us our guardian angel. He says it's a spiritual being of light to watch over our steps, to make us foresee certain dangers. Right. So when dangers are coming up on us, these guardian angels help us to know these dangers, to serve us as company in our solitude. So when we're by ourselves, we have a guardian angel there to be our company. And a staff for our journey. These guardian angels are helping us with our journey. These are beings that we call protectors. Yep. Now, this is kind of what we've always heard. But here are all the details in the scripture, guys. It's always good to have the scripture and the verses to point to so we can know exactly what we're talking about. But let's go on to verse 11. He says, "Never behave ungratefully to them, nor be deaf to their inspirations, for your strength alone will not be sufficient to move ahead in all the trials of life. You need those who go ahead of you and who know, because I reveal it to them, something of your future." Talking about our guardian angels. First of all, he said, don't be ungrateful. Don't belittle those things that they're doing for us. We're going to find out that they're doing a lot for us, a lot of stuff that we don't even know is going on in behind the scenes. These guardian angels are helping us with that. But notice this part right here. He says, "For your strength alone will not be sufficient to move ahead in all of the trials of life." Yeah, and guys, we're facing a tribulation here in 2019, 2020. We have a lot of trials that's coming up ahead of us. These guardian angels are going to play a very big role in what we do. Even the scripture says that most troublous parts of the tribulation, we're going to be able to see some of these angels. Some of these angels we're going to be able to see their work and see their actions. So he's saying, don't take it for granted that these guys, are here, because we actually need them. Then notice this part right here. He says, "Because I reveal to them something of your future." So our guardian angels know a little bit about our future. They know what's going to happen to us. So, you go back in your past and you can imagine, times when these guardian angels would have been protecting you or helping you. Maybe they were protecting you and helping you because they knew the missions that you have, ahead of you. They know how important you're going to be in the future, and such. I can remember a lot of times these angels got me out of stuff. I didn't know they existed. Existed or know they were around. I might have thought it was just luck or me being swift or whatever, but they have protected us all of this time to get us to this point so that we can finish out our missions that we have before us. Look at verse 12. "The struggle of those beings is very arduous until you achieve spirituality, for you do very little to help them on their delicate mission." All right. Now, key word here, guys, is achieve spirituality. See, before we become spiritually minded, meaning that before we become aware of the Father and his creation and what he expects of us and put our get our minds off of the material stuff and put it onto spiritual stuff. Before we become spiritually minded individuals, we don't help the guardian angels at all. We get in their way. We make it hard for them and make it difficult for them. We sitting there crying over cars and praying over this and praying over that. You could imagine the guardian angel sitting there with his hand on his head, just shaking his head, going, "Woe is me. I got to deal with this guy." You know, he don't even know what's important. And that's what he's talking about. Until we become spiritual beings, we don't help these guys at all. They are helping us as much as they can. Well, they are helping us with everything, but we aren't supporting them at all. We ain't doing anything to help them to help us, you know, at all. You know, you can imagine, we're like children. You know, the guardian angels, you know, are not really our parents, but it's like children. We are completely unaware of what's going on, while you have this figure above that's actually helping us with our day-to-day stuff, and we ain't got sense enough to be grateful for it. Look at verse 13. When your spirituality permits you to feel and prove the presence of your brothers and sisters who invisibly, without any ostentation, work for your welfare and your progress, you will feel sorrow at having made them to work and suffer so much due to your sins. Yeah, so once you have progressed, once you have been prepared, once you have climbed, you know, a few rungs of Jacob's ladder there, then you start to become aware how much these guys have done for you. Then it kind of dawns on you, makes you feel a little bit sad how much you've put these guys through, because you gotta realize they're working really, 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 really hard, you know, in this world to protect us from our own stupidity, which is what it boils down to, us doing dumb stuff. They are protecting us from ourselves. They're protecting us from others too, but you know, we're one of the main ones that's doing the dumb stuff. It says, yet when this comprehension arises in you, it will have done so because the light shines in your understanding, and from it will spring charity, gratitude, and understanding towards the guardian angels. We start to appreciate what they're doing in our life when we reach a spiritual maturity. As long as we are trapped in our materialism and our arrogance, guys, we're not going to even know that they're there. We're definitely not going to help them, but once we reach a certain level of maturity, then, you know, we can start to take into account what they're doing for us and not be so hard on these guys. Look at verse 19. The only distance that exists between you and God, or between you and the spiritual being, is not physical distance, but the spiritual distance originating from your lack of preparation, lack of purity, lack of will to receive spiritual inspirations and influence. Yeah, in another section, he says that he is closer to us than our eyelashes. The Father says that he is closer to us than our eyelashes. So it's not a physical distance that separates us. It's what it says here, a lack of preparation, meaning we haven't gone in and understood the commandments and the rules of the scripture and what it takes to be spiritual individuals. A lack of purity, meaning we're not obeying those things that we read in the scripture. Or a lack of will to receive spiritual inspiration and influence, meaning we won't turn off the television. We won't stop for a minute and meditate on those things that are coming from the Father, right? And it is these things that are creating a distance between us and the Father. We have to remove those things if we want to have a closer relationship with him. All right, look at verse 20. Never put that distance between yourselves and your master, or between yourselves and the spirit world, and you will always enjoy the benefits my love pours out over those who know how to seek it. Yeah, you don't let that distance separate us from the master or the spirit world. See, I've thought about doing a class on the rapture and what it actually is. And, you know, because there's a huge misunderstanding. People think we're about to get warped off to some, you know, cloud, and I guess we're going to sit up on a cloud for 1,000 years while we watch these people down on the earth or whatever. I'm not sure what people think is actually going to happen. But what the scripture says is going to happen, guys, is that we're going to change. We're going to become spiritual beings. While some of us are striving to become spiritually natured now, there's coming a day and a time when everybody on a planet, in a twinkling of an eye, is going to switch from being materialistic minded people to spiritualistic minded people, and the Father is going to be here dwelling as our King. So, and that's why they call it the Kingdom of Heaven. So, you know, we don't want to put this distance between us and the spirit world. We want to close the distance. We don't want to wait to the last moment before we become spiritual individuals. I know you've heard that saying, the bombs come down and we go up. Well, yeah, that's what it seems like when you read Revelations. It's like a nuclear bomb is what helps us to make that transition from the material world to the spirit world. And for some of us, it's actually going to mean a physical death. So we don't want to wait till the last minute. We want to close the distance ahead of time so we can have the opportunity to inherit the earth. But I'm getting off into some other subjects here. We're talking about guardian angels. So let's go on. It says, you will always have the feeling that the spiritual world vibrates together with the hearts of those who prepare themselves to feel it. Yeah, so once we prepared ourselves to feel the spirit world, even in where we sit at now, we can enjoy some of the benefits of the spirit world. I was listening to the third testament a few minutes ago, and we now have the ability to commune, I don't know what word it is, but we have the ability to spend time with our loved ones that are in the spirit world. Yeah, that. I should go pull out the verse for you, but it says that we have the ability to share time with dead people. We can't go where they at, and we can't bring them here. We can't use some type of, you know, what do you call it, familiar spirits, so we can hear their voices, hear what they saying. But we can, through like meditation and prayer, feel their presence, you know, and that's one thing that's available for us. All right. So that's just one part of it. You know, we find that in another section that there are individuals on other planets. This is the third testament of the Bible, guys, and it brings a wealth of information about both the spirit world, what's on other planets, and all of that. And you can find all of that on our channel. Not all of it, but you can find a lot of classes that we've put up so far over there on our channel at Hermes Academy. Just look around, hit the subscribe button, because we put these classes up all the time. But look at verse 21. He says, how great is the distance that the humanity of this time puts between themselves and the spiritual life. So great that it is for that reason that the men of today feel God to be infinitely distant from them and imagine heaven to be far away and unreachable. So this is why we feel like the Father is so far away, like he dwells off in some long place away. Like I said earlier, he's closer to us than our eyelashes, but yet we feel like he is way off in heaven, and heaven is someplace far, far away from us. This is why he says it's because we're not preparing ourselves. We're not doing those things to prepare ourselves in order to become closer to the spirit world. And what does it take? It takes adherence to the Bible, guys. I would start there in Exodus chapter 20 and read all the way to Exodus chapter 24, verse 7. And once we embrace that's the covenant. That's the covenant that we're all expected to live to. And you read there in chapter 23 of Exodus how it talks about an angel that will protect us through the tribulation. That's what he's talking about. When we have prepared ourselves and with the covenant, getting our life in line with the covenant and start to obey the covenant, then we're promised that our angel, the covenant angel, not necessarily the guardian angel, because the guardian angel is there anyway, but the covenant angel becomes closer to us and helps guide us through the tribulation. All right, y'all, this is a lot about angels and guardian angels over here. And what does it say? It was again chapter 41 of the third testament of the Bible. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up, but you guys go ahead and check the channel. Leave your comment, hit the like button, and subscribe. Hermes Academy. Power, patience, continence, and faith. We teach virtue.